Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can perform object detection using Eolo V10. So let's begin. For this tutorial, we'll be using the Spark Node dataset. So from here, you need to go to this link, and here you can select the format. So as of now, Eolo V10 is specifically not present, but the Eolo V8 format is similar to Eolo V10. So you can, you know, select Eolo V8 and download the zip file to your system. So once you have downloaded the zip file, you need to unzip it and put it in a in your main project folder. You need to rename your parking lot dataset folder to datasets, and here you will find three subfolders within it: train, test, and validation. So each of the three folders contain one images folder and a labels folder. Images contains all the different types of images, and labels contain a text file which contains all the bounding box related information and the name of the class. So in our case, we have two classes. One stands for space empty, and the other one stands for space occupied. So the entire dataset contains more than 12,000 images, but for the sake of this tutorial, I have only used a subset of the entire dataset. So for training, for training purpose, I am using only 5,000 images, as you can see over here. So before starting to code, you need to make sure that you have Ultralytics installed in your system. So as of now, this is the latest version of Ultralytics. So you need to copy this command and install Ultralytics. So here I have created my own separate Python environment, and I have installed Ultralytics already. So to see the Ultralytics version installed in your system, you can type pip list, and here you can see the version of Ultralytics that I have currently on my system. So it's 8.2.48. So this is the code for training your Eolo V10 model. So first we'll import the Eolo class from Ultralytics, and then we'll write model equals to Eolo V10n.pt. So we'll be using the smallest Eolo V10 model, and then we'll use the training method on this model. So here we'll choose the image size. The image size should be a multiple of 32. Here I've used epochs of 40. Batch size, you can keep it 16 or 32 as well, but sometimes GPU crashes when the batch size is too much. So it's better if you keep the batch size as 8, which is a nominal. And here you need to, mention the name of the folder where your model will be stored. Before running the code, let's first have a look at this data3.yaml file. Here you need to mention the path colon space the name of the folder preceded by two dots. Then you need to mention the training folder and the validation folder. Here we have two classes, space empty and space occupied. And yeah, that's it. That's all you have to write in the data.yaml file. Just to give you an overview, this is how our main project folder park count looks like. So here we have a training Python file. Here we have the data3.yaml file. And here we have our datasets folder, which contains the images and labels. So let's start our training. you have completed the training part, you will get this runs folder. This you need to go to this detect folder, and here you need to go to the folder which you had mentioned in your training file. Here we had mentioned this YOLO V10 and Park 40E. So you need to go over here, and then you need to go to the weights, and you need to pick up this file best.pt. Okay, so I copied this .pt file and stored it in this models folder, and I renamed it as park_best10.pt. Okay, next we'll use this model in our inferencing code. So now let's begin our inferencing part. So this is the image on which we'll be performing our inference and identifying how many spaces are occupied and how many spaces are vacant in a parking lot. So first we'll import a PIL and a YOLO library. This is the path where our model is located, and we'll get the label map using dtmodel.model.names. So let's execute this. So your class 0 stands for space empty and class 1 stands for space occupied. And now we'll open our image. Then we'll perform inferencing using this command. And yep, you can see the output. So this is the output, and you can, if you want, you can save the image using this argument. And when you give this argument, you need to give file name as well. And if you want to see the confidence as well, you can keep this as true. So if you keep this true, then you'll get the confidence as well. If you don't want this, then you can just keep it false. So yeah, this completes our YOLO V10 inferencing tutorial. So I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.